So now let's go back to the things that we need to operate a network. So we need a way to encode and interpret messages. So we saw that we can encode any message we want in bits, and then we can encode the bits on the wire. How that encoding actually works is pretty complicated. It's not something we're going to talk about in this class, but there are lots of different ways to do it. But we're figuring out ways for each 0 and 1 to encode that as something that we send along a wire, or it could be wireless. What we haven't talked about, which we are going to talk about soon, is what these high-level messages are. Right? We need ways to send messages that can be interpreted and understood at the other side. And so what we'll talk about next is how that works on the internet. As far as a way to route messages, for the internet, all of the routers along that path, well, a message comes in, it has a destination. The routers have to figure out the next destination to go to. And that's also quite a challenging problem. It's something we're not going to get into more detail in this class, but you can imagine different ways you might do this. A router might have a table that says, well, if you're in California and you want to send a message to Boston, you should first send it to Nevada because that's going in the right direction. That's not quite the way things work, because we saw that there was actually just one message, that really what you want to do was send it to San Jose, where you've got a big strong pipe that goes all the way to Boston. Finally, you need ways to decide who gets resources. And on our Greek network, we assume that the general could decide. The internet is much more of a Wild West than that. In the internet, there aren't any real rules for who gets resources. Everywhere along the network gets to decide on its own how to do that. And what we really get on the internet is just what we call best effort service. If your message needs to go over the same link as some other message, the router can only send one message at a time. It's up to the router to decide what to do. There are different policies that different routers follow. There's no general rule that is enforced on the whole internet. And this means that sometimes your packet might just get dropped. There's no guarantee when you send a message on the internet that it actually gets to where you want it to. So we're not going to talk more about these two in this class. I will encourage you to take a future networking class that will get into those details. We are going to talk a little bit about how the messages work for the web.